Hi, I'm Al from Just Trails. We're here with Sierra Trading Post today to talk to you about the different parts of a compass. Compasses come in many varieties. On one end, you've got compasses with a lot of sophisticated features for fairly intensive backcountry navigation applications. You have some compasses that are built specifically for sighting. On the other end, you've got compasses that are quite frankly just cheap. The type of compass you use depends entirely on what you want that compass to do. If you're in the backcountry, traveling long distances, relying on your map and compass skills, you're going to want a more expensive compass, one that's going to have the capabilities that you need. However, if all you need your compass to do is identify the cardinal directions, then a cheap compass will be fine. Regardless of the quality or the specific design of the compass you have, each compass is going to have some similar features. The first part of the compass we'll talk about is the housing. This is the liquid-filled center of the compass. It is always round, and every compass absolutely has to have one. The second part we'll talk about is the needle. The needle is easily identified because it's the part of the compass that's floating inside the housing. And every time you move or wiggle your compass, the needle is going to position itself to point in the same direction. The next part of the compass is the dial. Now the dial is the part of the compass that spins around the housing. Most of the dials will have degree marks on them. And degree marks are important so you can get a bearing. And not all compasses have the degree marks on the dial. Some compasses will have the degree marks inside the compass housing attached to the needle. The next part we'll talk about is the orienting arrow. Now the orienting arrow is also inside the housing, and it moves with the dial. It's generally in the shape of an outline of the needle itself. It's designed that way on purpose so that you can easily line up the orienting arrow with the needle. Now the orienting arrow is important because it helps orient your compass to the map. It also can be used to help you quickly continue following a bearing as you're moving through the countryside. The next part of the compass is the degree indicator. The degree indicator is at a fixed location on the surface of your compass. It's usually a line or a mark or a small triangle of some kind. And the purpose of the fixed indicator is to actually give you a bearing measurement. Next is the aiming line. The aiming line is nothing more than a straight line that runs through the center of your compass from one end to the other. It's very useful for helping you point your compass at distant objects. It's worth pointing out that the aiming line is also the degree indicator. Finally, we'll talk about the base of the compass. It's just the hard, clear, smooth plastic bottom that all the other parts of the compass are mounted on top of. It contains a lot of lines for measuring distance on various map scales, and it can also be used as a straight edge if you need to draw lines on your map. We hope you found this video helpful. If you have, give us a thumbs up. And for more navigation-related information, check out the videos on screen or click one of the links in the description box.